All right, welcome to Think Louder yet again. We are India's first and only LEGO speed build and review channel. We also include full reviews, some backgrounds, detailed builds, a lot of trivia and a lot more. Let's start building them. Well, today we are actually building a speedboat. That's the first water vehicle that we've done on this specific show. There you go, it looks pretty cool. Not a very complicated build, not a lot of parts either. Some of the views, you can see a beautiful four-cylinder engine in the back, four beautiful exhausts. We try to look for the specific model as well, but what you'll see are some examples of speedboats which have a rear engine. That's a beautiful rear propeller, I love that specific view. That's a catamaran speedboat, a very classic example. That's the hydroplane, one of the first inventions as well, quite a few years back. So here's how the box looks. It again comes in a very simple packaging and not a lot of parts, a couple of booklets, because typically all Technique models have two separate A and B builds. When you lay out all these parts, you really come to know how this is going to come together. You can see the engine components right in the front, the wings, the side wings, the wheels and the propeller and sort of the some of the beautiful parts that you see there. Now, it all starts with the engine block. I love building this. Almost all the LEGO Technique models have the same engine concept, the way they've modeled this. So pretty cool. Talking about the history of speedboats, also called as motorboats or powerboats. They're usually a boat which is powered by an engine. Some motorboats are fitted with inboard engines. Others have an outboard motor installed in the rear, containing the internal combustion engines, the gearbox and the propeller in one portable unit itself. Now, an inboard outboard contains a hybrid of an inboard and an outboard, where the internal combustion engine is installed inside the boat and the gearbox and the propeller are held outside the boat. There are two configurations of an inboard, V drive and direct drive. A direct drive has a power plant mounted near the middle of the boat, with the propeller shaft straight out of the back, where a V-drive has the power plant mounted in the back of the boat, facing backwards, having the shaft go towards the front of the boat, then making a V towards the rear. All confusing, but well, just take my word for it. The V-drive has become increasingly popular due to wakeboarding and wake surfing, where a person can stand behind the boat. Now, the earliest boat to be powered by a petrol engine was tested on the Necker River, by Gottlieb Daimler and Wilhelm Maybach in 1886, where they tested their long case clock engine. The first successful motor boat was designed by Priestine Brothers in Hull, England, under the direction of William Dent Priestman. The Daimler company began production of motor boats in 1897 from its manufacturing base in Coventry. Well, there you go, the models are complete. You can see it's beautiful, it's very, very simple. While there's a lot of history, I didn't just have enough time to cover it. I would rate this build about 5 bricks out of 10. I think you should definitely try building this. Do look out for the next video where we are going to cover the race boat. Till then, happy building and do let us know what you think. Cheers.